Hello everyone, welcome to BIMModeler.com. This is Raj. In this video tutorial, you will be learning how to create a line-based family. If you have not watched the previous tutorial as array-based family, you can go back and watch it. This is going to be the continuous series from the previous tutorial. And you will be able to download this hands-on file from our website BIMModeler.com. Or if you need any services related to BIM modeling, Revit architecture, Revit MEP or parametric family creations, you can contact in BIMModeler.com. With that, let's start the tutorial. I'll be minimizing this project file. Let's start new family. I'm going to create a generic model family, which is a architectural feature as a component. Close the background view and I'm opening the front view WT to create the tile view. We'll be able to see both the views side by side and create an extrusion for the rectangle. I need a rectangle 100 by 100 like this, and I like to create an equal dimensions in both the sides. Equal. The dimension would be, say for example, 50 on each sides. So select the line and apply 50 on each side. If you change one side, automatically the other side changes. Finish it. You'll be able to see that in the front view. And I like to keep this height as 25 like this. And create blend. I'll use the pick command. I'm creating the bottom. I hope everybody knows blend. If you don't know, you can follow the series from the beginning. Create this four lines. Click edit top. I need the top face as round, something like this, and finish it. Now if you see that the blend object which is created. But if you see in 3D, the four corners joins in two places. I don't want like that. I want to edit that, going back to the blend again by selecting it. Edit top face, which is circle. Use the split command. In each quadrant, create one split approximately and finish it. Now, if you check in 3D, your objects will be clearly joined in each corners. Now stretch this line to 25 on this place, and we need to have this something like this around 50. Now I like to have a small object in this place as a round, so we can create revolve in this place in the front view, and say for example from this corner to the end and to the top, say 10 arc, something like this, the shape that you needed. Once it is done, we are good. Create the axis line on the center, finish it. So it's creating an error. The profile must not cross each other. Let me do the align command, each one with the axis of the object, and try to finish that element. Let's go back and see that this object is extending further. We don't need that. We can control it like this on the each corner. Finish it. Now if you see that in 3D, object is created, the architectural feature. Save this family in the project location, single family. You can name it as your requirement. Save. Now we need to create another family which is named as line-based family from the line-based family template. File, new, family, metric, generic model, line-based family. Select the template, select open, close the background view, save this family to the same place, line-based architecture feature. Save this. Once it is done, go back to your previous family, which is single family. Load this family back to the line-based family, not to the project. Place your family wherever you need. So far in this case, I like to start this family from the origin, or if I want to start from this place, I can do it by placing here. I can create the another reference line and align this each other and lock it together. Now if I want to control this space, and if I want to maintain 100 distance always, I can create the dimension and lock this as well. Now if you remember, we will be able to create the array using any object which is from here, and we are creating a linear array from this point, or from this point the distance that you needed. So we have a 50 gap for each element, so we can take it from here, and the second point will be center of this place like this. So we may have, without spacing, based on your spacing, you can say you need 100 between the each elements. In that case, create another reference plane. We need gap between elements 50, so 150. And do the array command again, linear from the center to the center. So we need n number of elements, say for example 5 elements like this, and control it by using align and spacing. You'll be able to create this parametric features like what is space you need between these elements, such as for example we need element to element gap 150, element gap. Now, if you select this array feature, you'll be able to see the number of elements. Select that option in the option bar. You'll be able to add parameter. Depends on the version that you are using. Sometimes it may appear here based on the recent versions. Add parameters, which is number of elements. We have the total length, and we have the space between the elements. And we'll be able to divide that, and we'll be able to calculate the actual number of elements need to be there. So we can go ahead and go to the type property, number of elements here. So we'll be able to use this length divided by element gap. There's totally 8 elements if I apply. So it's supposed to be instance parameters, because we are using instance parameter all the places. So let's keep this as the instance. On the other side, let's apply and select OK. So this is how you'll be able to create this elements. Once, if you're stretching this length element, the number of elements will get increased automatically. If you see that there is a reference line in the bottom, so the Revit will control this reference line length from your pick positions. Automatically it will be adjusted. Now it is completed. Go to 3D and view this as element like this, and load into your project, which is here. And do you want to save? Yes, I want to save this. There are two ways that you can place on face or place on work plane. So at the moment I'm using place on face options, and I'll be able to draw anywhere that I needed or any direction that I needed like this, and you will be able to see that the elements created again. So you can create it in this direction or in this place, or you'll be able to use the pick line option, and you will be able to pick the line and the element features will be placed automatically in your object like these. Now you can delete it, the unnecessary elements in all the places. Select the pick point and you will be able to modify it again. That's it. So I hope this will be the basic training about line-based family. I hope you learned it. If you want to practice, you will be able to visit the bimmodeler.com and you can download this family and use it in your project. If you need similar family files or Revit architectural or MEP modeling, you can contact us on bimmodeler.com. Thank you so much for watching.